Welcome to Ravens Over. Please subscribe to my channel, also hit the notification bell, and like this video and share. Here's an update on Dominique Jackson, 30 years old. And I want to share the story about the alleged person they found arrested. Share this video.
I created this channel for people with different
transgenders murdered.
To support you. There's a PayPal on top.
People murdered. One
thing. There are a lot of times people can't stand in the truth, but you find one that does support them. Make allies. Sure they do not fall within a marginalized community as not being in existence. And you know music. That they're hard to find people that create a channel that caters to people who are different and stand in the truth.
Fishing
and the here. Allies sit back and say, well, I have no problem with other people.
PayPal.
Let me just stand in here to learn
support
and learn.
Those
no judgment.
Who support
so,
you.
I love you.
Stand
now, this is an update on Dominique Jackson, 30 years old. Now, I reported this story on February the 4th, 2021. It was titled, Black Transgender Woman Dominique Jackson, 30 years old in Mississippi, that was killed. Now, in that, I put in a description that basically we was trying to find someone to, who was the person that allegedly that killed her and stuff, or the person that was of interest. So basically, a lot of y'all, I do appreciate the fact that you shared the video as much as you could, and I put the Crime Stoppers number. And when I did the story stuff, basically went out, a Jacksonville police arrested a suspect in the shooting death of the 30-year-old Dominique Jackson. Now, a man is arrested on January 2021 of a homicide of a transgender woman. So like I said before, it's allegedly, and if case you remember how the news clip went out, check this out.
First at 6 tonight, there is a push to classify one of Jackson's 13 homicides a hate crime. Last month, a transgender woman named Dominique Jackson was found shot and killed in her car. 12 News' Anna Ferris talked to Dominique's friends who don't want her case to be forgotten.
Friends of Dominique Jackson say she was one to remember.
A very likable person. She's a person that you would not forget.
On January 25th, someone shot and killed Dominique. The 30-year-old was found in her car on Rose Street. There's been no movement in the case. Dominique was transgender. Her friends believe that may be why she was killed and say Jackson police should be doing more.
Over the course of times, we've had multiple transgender crimes throughout our city, and it seems to me that the city of Jackson is ignoring those, and they're performing this indirect discrimination matter that concerns me and the LGBT community itself.
JPD spokesperson Sam Brown says right now there's no evidence to support a hate crime. I looked into Mississippi law. The state hate crime mentions sexual orientation or gender identity.
We have to do something, and we have to do it now. And we're calling upon the state representatives here to do what they should. There are some things that we sit back and we watch our government and we watch our city representatives talk about, and we're looking for a particular situation, you know, as to what is a priority in our city. We need to know prioritize. What are we going to change?
Dominique's investigation is still ongoing.
So as I was doing some digging about her death and stuff, this report update is 12. February 12, 2021. This is an update. It says the guy's name is Branden McLaurin, 25 years old, has been charged with connection to the crime that happened on Rose Street on Grand Avenue on January 2021. Now, if you want to find out more information, I always say thank you guys and girls, everybody who basically tried to help out as far as getting these people that hate our sisters and kill them apprehended. There was something that went out even on Twitter. Check this out. Here is the update. Jackson Police Department, February 12, 2021. Update: suspect Branden, 25 years old, arrested and charged with a fatal shooting that occurred on Rose Street and Grand Avenue last month. So allegedly, Branden is the one. Lauren is the one who allegedly shot and killed her. And it says that's the update, that the victim was fatally wounded on Rose Street and Grand Avenue early this week, identified as Dominique Jackson, 30 years old. And that was the tips that y'all basically helped, you know, thank everybody. Because like I said before, a lot of times when we do these things, by you sharing these videos, it get actually get the guy or person of interest arrested and stuff. So this is being reported as of February the 12th, which means that it's this month, 2021. So
There it is. 25 years old, Branden. Suspect. That suspect. This is the alleged killer.
So I could say my sister, rest in peace, and the family and friends, you're in my prayers. And I'd like to thank everybody who shared the video. And I'd like to thank everybody who showed interest and cared about another human being that had a right to be here. She was only 30 years old. Her life was just beginning. It's taken away, and for no reason at all. So allegedly, this guy is supposed to be the one who allegedly killed her. It's conflicting. One is saying that he was arrested back in February the 12th. The update is saying that he was arrested and has been charged. So it's conflicting. So it's saying that the update. So like I said before, subscribe to my channel. If I get any more information, I will let you know. And I appreciate you, especially the people who shared the video, because one thing I can say is RIP does nothing. You can't keep killing us. We put RIP the next girl, RIP. We have to fight back. And I thank you all for sharing the video, because due to the fact that you shared the video, my personal opinion, you're the reason why he got apprehended, because it would go cold if nobody does nothing. So I thank everybody on this channel, because you are the soldiers for our sisters. You are the first that have the voices for these girls that's been killed. So thank you for sharing the video. I do appreciate it. You know, I just want to do this update on this. I'm not going to stand alone. Y'all can share the video. Y'all can comment below. Let me know how y'all feel about this video. Like I said before, this allegedly, in my opinion, this guy, I don't know. But I get many more information and updates, so make sure you subscribe to this channel. At the top, there's Instagram button. You follow me, I'll follow you back. If you want to donate to this channel, there's a PayPal on top. Please be safe out there. And y'all can comment below. Let you know I love you. And thank you for watching. Catch the read.